それでは引き続きましてヘルスケアシステム事業の説明を始めさせていただきます。
We'd like to start the presentation of the healthcare business unit. The presenter is CEO of Healthcare Business Unit, Mr. Watanabe. My name is Watanabe from the Healthcare Business Unit. 2015. Let us take a review of 2015. Business classification, segment classification has been changed. So, industry distribution business unit of the 160 billion that's been carved out to that business unit. Now, 2015 actual, 104% year on year in terms of revenue based on the new classification, and 7.6% is the operating income ratio, improvement of 1.3 points over the previous year. Major reasons. Testing and reagents went well in terms of revenues, and diagnostics and clinicals improved profits. Now, major progress in 2015 are shown here. New areas, new business, Hitachi Chemical, cell manufacturing business, they made an entry into this business. So regenerative medicine program is being enhanced at Hitachi. And in April, Hitachi Medical Corporation and Hitachi Aloka Medical have been integrated into Hitachi Limited. So global one healthcare business structure has been enhanced. Next, I'd like to talk about the business overview and overall strategies. Innovating healthcare, embracing the future. This is the new slogan for the business. Diagnostics, clinical, testing, reagents, and informatics. These are the three core domains. Revenue breakdown by business field, by company, and by region, as can be seen here. For diagnostics and clinical, it is taken care of by the healthcare business unit. And Hitachi High Technologies is covering testing and reagents. And 6% is covered by Healthcare BU. And informatics, Healthcare BU, Hitachi Data Systems, and Information and Communications. That is how it is split. This is a major change. There has not been a major change in this structure from last year. Now, our healthcare business, social innovation business, this is one of the pillars of Hitachi's social innovation business. We want to lead the change in the society. That's the idea behind it. We have special features. One is solutions. Innovation is to be delivered to the customer. That is one. And the other is from energy to public. We want to take advantage of the comprehensive power of Hitachi. And therefore, going forward, our focus areas will be digital, service, BU coordination, front BU coordination. Those will be capitalized on aggressively. 2018, midterm management plan targets, revenue 440 billion, operating income, EBIT margin, 10% each. The target for 2018 used to be 600 billion. That is how it was explained until now. But given the environmental change, investment plan was reviewed and revised. And foreign exchange is another element. And low profitable business will be shrunk. And there's the classification, the reclassification of business segments, which is about 40 billion in total. So this is the revised target. Going forward, innovation capability would be enhanced. We want to become a global major player, and that thinking has not been changed. So in benchmarking, this is how we position ourselves. Diagnostics, clinical, testing reagents, informatics. In our portfolio, we want to become a solution provider. Hitachi Medical, it was an imaging diagnostics company, Siemens, Philips, Siemens, Toshiba. We used to be benchmarked against those players, but going forward, therapy and informatics, with those portfolios, we will be benchmarking ourselves so that we can build a stronger position. From April, this is a new structure, healthcare business unit. As a front organization, this will be driving the business overall. Healthcare company, in the past, Hitachi Medical and Hitachi Aloka have been absorbed, and power and some parts of information has been transferred. And based on that, they will be serving the front function. As for Hitachi High Technologies, in April, we talked about the midterm business plan. Biomedical business is going to be the priority business. As for Hitachi Chemical, regenerative medicine and genetics diagnostics will be the focus area. And service platform business unit is going to be offering IoT platform on a shared basis. Such comprehensive power of Hitachi will be leveraged in rolling out this business. Next, innovation and collaborative creation for new growth. The environment surrounding healthcare is changing very rapidly. There is a mountain of challenges, as you might already know. Society, customers' challenges are to be answered through innovation. We have two types of innovations here. Healthcare innovation is as a social system, healthcare, payer, provider, policymakers, and reduction of healthcare expenses is a big theme here. So innovation in that area is one pillar. And the other one is clinical innovation. Medical quality is to be enhanced, and we want to be making a contribution there. So these are the two priority areas. Now, before going into specifics, our thinking about innovation is described here. Let me talk about two things. One is that we want to co-create with customers through open innovation. So this is going to be our focus area. And the other one is IoT platform, cross-cutting platform called Lumada is going to be used so that new services, digital services, can be provided to the customers. So far, IoT cases, utilization cases, includes MRI, prediction maintenance service, as well as examination cards, transfer of medical images. We have been providing these services to the customers. Through this, we want to systematically, including analytics, enhance Lumada. So healthcare, various applications of healthcare will be built on top. Going forward, digital is going to be the critical point in winning the competition. As for healthcare innovation, there is the operational service, hospital management reform, digital health, and integrated community care systems. These are the focus areas for us. In advanced countries, including Japan, healthcare providers are shifting from hospitals to regions, localities, and from prevention and from various perspectives, hospital management reform is underway. So we want to be able to respond to these needs through innovation. Clinical innovation, smart operation, solution for each clinical area, utilization of clinical data, and life cycle support. These are going to be the focus areas. For example, smart cyber operation therapy. IoT is going to be introduced into operation theater. We do this through government, industry, private sector collaboration with Tokyo Women's Medical University. Hitachi will be taking the lead. So these two types of innovation, about 20 billion of revenues are being produced. And in 2018, we want to double this. And furthermore, including M&A, we want to top up this number. So overall, from a product business, we will be transforming ourselves into a service-oriented business. Next, change portfolio and main businesses. On the left-hand side is the current position, and on the right-hand side, we have the targets for 2018. Starting with the diagnostics and clinical, ultrasound and PBT, we are aiming to become global number one. On the other hand, concentration, selection, and focus is what we do. Commoditized areas and niche areas, we will make a decision on selection and focus. Testing and reagents, growth areas will be genetics and microbes. Together with reagents manufacturers, we will be working on those areas. And laboratories of hospitals and laboratory centers, total engineering solutions will be provided to these labs. That is how we will be growing this business. Informatics, this is a key to creating innovation, integrated community care systems, as well as analytics in North America will be launched. three businesses. This is the portfolio. Vertical axis is profitability, and the horizontal axis is growth rate. This is how it is plotted. As you can see from this diagram, currently our portfolio is such that testing and reagents is driving our profits. But in 2018, diagnostics and clinical and informatics will be enhanced so that three businesses will be well balanced in making a contribution to profits and profitability. Global number one. One of the businesses aiming at global number one is radiation therapy. PBT, Hitachi has a very strong position, and that is going to be the entry point for expanding X-ray therapy, advanced research, analytics, and therapy planning system. So in radiation therapy, we want to be providing a total solution. Analytics. There is a strong need for analytics, clinical data analysis, and verify and predict therapy and reducing side effects to enhance and improve the quality of care. We're working together with advanced hospitals to carry out joint projects. Last year, St. Jude and in the U.S., three facilities have started therapy. And in terms of contracts won, Johns Hopkins and Hong Kong, we received five orders. There's a strong response. So in order to become number one, we will be moving forward. The direction of growth, there are two directions. One is the high-end system. Japan, U.S., from Japan, U.S., China, Europe, and other parts of Asia, we will be rolling out the high-end models in these different areas. And as the base broadens, small-sized or low-end models and systems will also be rolled out. So these are the two points. Another area to become global number one is ultrasound of the diagnostic system. This is an easy-to-use equipment. Growth rate is 5%. And therefore, this market is a market where we have a tailwind blowing. Hitachi's position is number three in the world. So these are the strengths that we want to capitalize on in building this business forward. Specifically speaking, three growth strategies are in place. One is major clinical areas, including cardiology. We want to differentiate with unique application. And the other one is diseases and various combinations. We want to be providing most optimal solutions. Breast cancer is the area that we are working on. Such integrated areas, we want to be providing solutions to. And POC and in emerging markets, we want to be offering portable ultrasound equipment. So these are the three strategies that are to be followed. Towards 2018, revenue of 100 billion, 90% will come from global business. So global business is going to be driving our growth. That is the type of 3 years that we will have. We need to expand our sales network, and we need to invest in sales networks and informatics, as well as operational reform. Those are things that we have to work on. In terms of regions, North America and China are focus areas. Depending on countries, business models may be different from one another. For the United States, informatics will be utilized to drive innovation-style business. And in April, Hitachi America, we have established a dedicated team. China, on the other hand, the market is now going through change. Privatization is underway. And China Manufacturing 2025, they are turning to domestic production. So we need to accommodate to that change in the Chinese market. Next, reinforcement of business structure and investment for growth. This graph shows 2014 is the base year, SG&A, how it has been improved over the years on a cumulative basis. 2014 through 2015, 0.5 percentage point improvement was observed. And towards 2018, we want to top this up by 2.2 points. smart transformation has to be evolved going forward. Especially Hitachi Medical and Hitachi Aloka have been integrated, and we want to harvest the benefits of such integration. Another thing is generation of cash. CCC, as shown here, from 2014 to 2018, we want to have the CCC cycle. 2014 was 179 days, which is very long. PBT, as well as MRI, magnets, these have very long production lead times. So that's one factor. And in doing sales, there will be some lending activities to the customers. This is a unique practice to this industry. So those are the specific factors. But even after those factors, we believe that there is room for improvement. From April of last year, SCM reform has been promoted inside the organization. In 2015, through these efforts, we have already seen results. So team is working as one, working towards our target in 2018. Now, revenues, 100 billion growth is aimed at, and more than half of that will come from organic growth, CAGR 6%. This is above market growth. That is the plan of our growth. And about half of this will come from M&A, especially informatics. And we're aiming to become number one in certain businesses. And those are the areas that we're contemplating making investments into. For general investment, housekeeping investments and other recurring investments, those are to be minimized. And for R&D, 8% is the margin, and we want to enhance this 9% so that informatics and ultrasound and technologies beyond, we want to be making investments. Percentage against revenue is to be raised from to 9% from 8. Lastly, from 2015 to 2018, this is the waterfall in revenues as well as adjusted operating income. This is the waterfall picture. In 2016, as for the number for 2016, from 2015, 101% was the growth in revenues, and operating income came down slightly because of foreign exchange. In terms of our business performance, it was a little difficult. But for 2016, over the three-year period, we want to solidify the business base, and towards growth, we want to be making the first step. So this is going to be a very important year for us. Lastly, 2018. Targets, revenues of 440 billion and operating income ratio of 10%. These are the targets. Thank you very much. We will now take questions. In addition to Mr. Watanabe, CSO and CTO of Healthcare Business Unit, Mr. Osakabe, will be answering the questions. And also Mr. Komachi, Deputy General Manager of Corporate Finance, will be taking questions. Any questions from the floor? Yes.
On these great plans on boosting the operating margin to 10% by 2018. But I was comparing your operation with, for example, GE's ultrasound business and Philips, and your operating margin is still a little bit behind theirs. So based on your knowledge, what do you think are the differences that account for the differences in margins, and how do you plan on bridging the gap going forward?
Excuse me, may I have your name and company? Please?
Oh, it's David Louis, Qualcomm Management.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much for your question. And so we are running on a very similar business for the Hitachi Medical, Imaging Diagnostic, and with the GE, and the Siemens and the Philips. So as you mentioned, that so there's a big difference of the operating margin. So one of the reasons is the scale. So so they are running the operation more than $10 billion. So there's a big gap. So and we need to think about and how we compete with them in profitability. So one of our direction is a focus. So that we are focusing on some product and we have a strengths such as ultrasound and the regions. And so that's the one and point number one. And point number two is that we do not intend to be under similar business portfolio like under GE and Siemens. So as I mentioned, that we are going to the unique position in combination of imaging and diagnostic and the therapeutic and the informatics all together. So that's the way how and we can improve our profitability.
Thank you.
Any other questions?
Thank you. Question. Page 7. Sorry about asking the same question every time. By company, you have healthcare, Hitachi High-Tech, and others. But in the Hitachi group, why is it that healthcare is not brought together into a single entity? I think there are certain reasons why, so if you could explain that. What is the benefit of separating out into different entities? Why don't you bring them all into one entity? I've always wondered why, if you could explain. One reason is that historical circumstances that leads to different companies in these different entities. For example, testing and reagents, healthcare business unit, and Hitachi High-Tech Technologies, they both cover this area, and there are synergies. So at the business level, synergy is being pursued. But Hitachi High-Tech Technologies should be captured into healthcare business unit. I think that's the gist of your question. But this is a listed company, and they have various businesses. So at this current point in time, I really cannot comment on that possibility. So in those realities, healthcare business. We want to show this as one business to the customers to try to strengthen this business. So the business unit structure, this is one of the aims of this reorganization. The front should capture the needs of the customers to try to drive this business. So operation-wise, we want to cover those areas. Hitachi Medical and Hitachi Aloka Medical, PBT is separated out into a different business unit. Originally, Hitachi Medical president was saying that they should be brought together because they are doing similar things. But PBT business, in terms of business size, because the sizes are different, why this is organized in this fashion? Business opportunities. You're now in a growth period. At a glance, it seems so, but what do you think? PBT, it's been 20 years since we started this business. Accelerator technology is being used to give high-level therapy. So this is a leading-edge technology program. So power systems company with technology has been leading this effort until now. But as you pointed out, as this spreads around the globe, healthcare system business, we are of the view that this is going to be pursued as part of the healthcare system business. 4-3, we are saying that we are aiming to become a total solution provider. So in that sense, X-ray therapy, Hitachi Medical has been providing that service. So PBT, it will be brought together with PBT in the same business unit. High-end as well as low-end therapy would be proposed to the customers. And in terms of therapy planning, obviously, customers want one operation, one workflow. That is the needs of the customers. And analytics, clinical data analysis, these will be bundled together. Radiation oncology domain will be attacked by bundling these services together. Any other questions? Question. Page 9, 10% target that you mentioned on page 9, Hitachi High Technologies, testing and reagents, they have high profitability business. So if I exclude that in trying to capture an image, healthcare units' profitability, 1 or 2%, that is assumed in actuals, but the target appears to be about 4 to 5%. So enhancement of profitability, healthcare business unit inside Hitachi Limited, how much, what is the target? What are the measures being planned to enhance profitability at Hitachi Limited? If you could give us a separate view, 4-2 would show you an easy to understand picture. Testing and reagents, more than 80% comes from Hitachi High-Tech driving profitability. That is how it is today. And as for diagnostics and clinical and informatics, we want to raise profitability of these businesses, and that will be done in the healthcare business unit. So next year, 5% is the hurdle given by Mr. Higashihara. Especially for diagnostics and clinical, we want to prioritize areas. Ultrasound and radiation therapy will be growth areas, and others will go through selection and focus process, and informatics as of now. Various incubation investments are being made, so it's almost zero today. So by 2018, we really want to be bringing this up. For example, page 29, you have structural reform, reducing unprofitable products. 10 billion is the number here. But what are the unprofitable products as you identify them? And what are the ones that will be subject to this structural reform? Can you be more specific to try to improve profitability if you have any concrete plans for enhancing profitability? What we have been doing in the past, for example, CT, primary care, will be the focus, and electronic medical records will be focusing in small and medium-sized hospitals. Given the current status, we want to optimize these businesses. Now, diagnostics, imaging, China and Korea, well, this is an area where there's going to be commoditization going low end. So rather than expanding this business, we want to have an optimal size operation. And as for niche products, we want to really examine whether we will pursue them or not. Thank you very much for your answer. Any other questions?
Hi. The clinical analyzers, a core business for the healthcare BU, and also how can Hitachi High-Tech be properly integrated with the rest of the healthcare BU when it's a publicly listed company? Thanks.
Excuse me, may I have your name and company, please?
Yeah, I'm Drago Stefanescu from Ontario Teachers.
So you mentioned that the clinical changer, a clinical analyzer, so is it an IVD product? So, and Hitachi High-Tech and is the covering and the high end of and the clinical analyzer IVD product, and Hitachi and healthcare BU and is providing kind of a different product, mid range products such as allergy analytics. So, I think that we and have a good synergy and working to and the market. So that's one way. One point number one. And point number two is and we have a customer who is providing analytic service and to the patient. So we have a capability of engineering to those customers. So that we are working together and to provide more competitive total solution to the customers. So that's how and we are working together at this point in time.
A second question is the partnership with Philips. Can you maybe provide a few more details about how that works and what exactly are you aiming to achieve with that partnership? Thanks.
So we made an announcement and in back in April, March, as that we are working on with Philips for the DNA. So that's kind of a vendor neutral archive for the parks. So we are working on the joint marketing with them. So that's the first step. But we are quite interested in how we can collaborate with the informatics area with Philips. And because we have a strong capability for the IT platform, so they have the capability for healthcare services. So that's the future opportunity. But at this point in time, as we made announcement, and our collaboration is about the vendor neutral archive and to the customer.
他にご質問ございませんでしょうか。
Any other questions?
ありがとうございます。サークルクロス。
Question. Last year, the discussion was dissipated. I think there was an improvement this year. I have two questions. One, R&D, 8% vis-à-vis revenue, maybe too low. Siemens and GE, they have about 10%, and revenue is 1 trillion, and they have 100 billion in R&D, and you're trying to expand your business. I think you may need more R&D expenditure. That's my one thing. And service business, which is not disclosed. Diagnostics, when you talk about several tens of trillions of yen, Siemens and others are making profits in that area. How much is your service, and how do you intend to expand this? And leasing may become very important. Depending on hospitals, where you lease from will be very important. Now, Hitachi Capital, when they are organized in that fashion, how is leasing business to be changed? So can you talk more about service? Now, R&D, 10% or more may be needed. What's your point? As CEO of this business unit, I think there needs to be more R&D to strengthen our business. That's my desire. But as we try to grow our business through steps and phases, 8% to 9%, how can we maximize the result? Well, we need focus. We should be focusing in the areas we're strong in. And another thing is open innovation, working together with customers, with physicians, co-creation will become important, especially in PBT. Top cancer hospitals are our customers. We're now able to have such relationships in the United States. We have enhanced in terms of quality. So the amount may be only 8 or 9%, but in terms of quality, we want to improve the effectiveness. That's our stance vis-à-vis R&D. And your second question about service. In service, there is a variety of services involved. One is maintenance and support. Maintenance and support services. This is a steady source of revenue for us, a big one. And GE and Siemens were no different from them in this regard. And hospitals, operation services, as well as receiving contracts for outsourcing as a bundle. There are ways to expand this. And GE and Siemens are now going through a trial and error stage to try to expand their business. That's how we understand them to be doing. And operation service, for example, PET operation service, as well as imaging center's operation service. This is something that we have been doing more than 10 years in Japan. So we want to expand this business as we capture the needs of our customers. Now, leasing. It is true that customers make purchases making use of leases. So leasing is a very important business. With Hitachi Capital, we have been working together with them in the past. There are various leasing opportunities. It's not just going to be limited to Hitachi Capital. So we're thinking of various working relationships to provide the best solutions to our customers. Now, service, in terms of revenue contribution, what is the percentage? And over the long term, where do you want to take it to? And as for leasing business, off the balance sheet, is it off the balance sheet? For example, Toshiba Medical, in their case, on a non-consolidated basis, it's off the balance sheet. But on the consolidated basis, it's on the balance sheet. And as they sold to Canon, what was held by Mizuho was sold. But what is the case with you? Well, service contribution rate. We had been disclosing up to the last year. 23% was the target for 2015. That was the projection that we made. So 2015 ended with that level. Now, towards 2018, we want to raise this to 30%. That is the target for 2018. And lease accounting. Consolidated and non-consolidated. We don't necessarily show the differences. For leasing business, they are treated properly and are being reflected on our P&L. Depending on the customer, because they can't hold them on their own, they are asking Hitachi to own. So there are various arrangements, and depending on that, business profitability or ROA by segment may be different. Is it going to be entrusted to Hitachi Capital overall, or is there such a function within Hitachi healthcare business unit? Hitachi Capital, the leasing business that they did in healthcare area is about 20 billion. Where we were involved in is about 10 billion. And of this 10 billion, accounting-wise, it is treated appropriately. Sorry to belabor on this point. Of this 10 billion that you're involved in, does this still exist? And there are other leasing assets other than this? How does it look like? Lease contracts is entered into by Hitachi Capital and the customers. So we just sell to Hitachi Capital. Hitachi Capital is now an equity method affiliate. Is this 10 billion outside? You're involved, but this has been, this is now an equity method affiliate owned 10 billion. This is a separate matter. Now, inside the healthcare business unit, this doesn't remain. This has been carved out and separated out. So that concludes the briefing on the healthcare business unit. Thank you very much.